Performance Drone Works, PDW, a US AI and drone technology company, demonstrated an interesting concept where its proprietary C100 quadcopter was used to lase targets for the F-35. The demonstration involved the fifth-generation stealth fighter jet working in tandem with the UAS to conduct precision airstrikes on targets. This integration represents a next-generation air combat doctrine where target illumination and munition guidance are no longer dependent on manned aircraft and could be performed by low-cost, expendable drones. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why PDW C100 quadcopter cuing F-35 for strikes will revolutionize warfare. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The test carried out in July involved the PDW C100 drones illuminating ground targets with laser designators before the F-35A Lightning II fighter jets released and guided four inert GBU-12 Pavway, two bombs in precision airstrikes. According to a statement released by the company, the Leonardo Stag-5 laser target designator was used for target designation. The demonstration featured three separate engagements at ranges of 1,000, 1,500, and 2,000 meters from the C-100 to the target. The UAS was able to loiter for nearly 35 minutes before illuminating its targets. Viewers may note that GBU-12 Pavway 2 is a laser-guided bomb based on the Mark 82 500-pound 230-kilogram bomb with a range of 9 miles or 14.5 kilometers. PDW CEO and co-founder Ryan Gurry said, "This is the second in a series of demonstrations aimed to prove the C-100 as the ultimate organic fires platform." Gurry added, "The C-100 offers a huge leap in tactical flexibility for the warfighter, and PDW is ready to equip our forces with a system that can provide that support across various domains." This demonstration validated the C-100's role as a modular strike enabler, integrating laser target designator capability for rapid target handoff to indirect fire, close air support, and maritime platforms, PDW said in a statement. "As a standoff targeting solution, the system delivers organic precision lasing from extended ranges, reducing exposure to manned elements while enhancing operational reach." PDW noted, "This exercise demonstrated the ability of an operator to safely mark targets from a standoff range with the C-100 for joint fires capabilities without need for supporting aircraft." The statement by PDW indicated that all munitions hit their intended targets. This showcased that the F-35A can accurately engage ground targets without needing to descend to low altitudes for visual identification or depend on low-flying aircraft and larger drones to perform that role. The C-100 is a man-packable, heavy-lift quadcopter platform that features world-leading flight endurance, capable of missions of up to 74 minutes with a payload. The low swap, size, weight, and power, drone easily folds down into a small rucksack and can be deployed and airborne in under 2 minutes. The system supports payloads of up to 10 kilograms and offers universal third-party payload integration, compatible with multiple protocols. Standard options include Trillium's military-grade EOIR gimbals. For improved operator awareness, the aircraft is equipped with a dedicated fixed flight camera, providing first-person view. Its advanced autonomy suite includes object detection, visual inertial odometry for GNSS denied operations, and vision-based collision avoidance. Built for rugged conditions, it operates reliably in temperatures from minus 20 degrees Celsius to 57 degrees Celsius, minus 4 degrees Fahrenheit to 135 degrees Fahrenheit, and is resistant to dust and water ingress. Performance specifications include a 6-mile, 10-kilometer range, a top speed of 40 miles per hour, 65 kilometers per hour, and a service ceiling of 12,000 feet, 3,658 meters. The drone features four extended landing legs and four foldable arms, each equipped with a two-bladed rotor, and is compact enough to be transported on the back of a tactical vehicle. In December last year, PDW secured contracts worth over $15.3 million to supply the C-100 small unmanned aerial system to the U.S. Army. At the time, PDW co-founder and CEO Ruan Gurry stated, "The C-100 drone is redefining battlefield agility and operational effectiveness, enabling soldiers to execute missions autonomously without the need for external fire support." This joint air warfare concept enables operators to identify targets from a safe distance, removing the need for F-35s to descend to low altitudes or rely on other aircraft for target acquisition. The approach greatly reduces risk to both costly manned fighters and their pilots. By pairing expendable tactical drones with stealth fighters, U.S. Air Force is shaping a new doctrine. The fighter remains at standoff range to deliver precision strikes, while drones take on the higher-risk roles of ISR, electronic warfare, and target acquisition. This concept differs from the loyal wingman approach, where larger and more expensive drones are designed to fly alongside manned fighter jets. However, both strategies share the same objective: building a networked, cost-effective air combat ecosystem that integrates manned and unmanned platforms. The move comes as U.S. military is phasing out a key close combat system, the A-10 Warthogs. This retirement process is expected to be completed by end of this year, with all A-10s scheduled for decommissioning as the Air Force shifts focus to newer, more advanced fighter jets. Renowned for its unmatched close air support capabilities, the A-10 is being retired as the U.S. military adapts to evolving threats that demand greater stealth and speed. Though the Warthog proved invaluable in past conflicts, its aging design makes it less viable for modern combat scenarios, especially in strategically critical regions like the Indo-Pacific. The C-100 with stealthy F-35 could not only fill this gap, but enable more effective combat performance. This opens up lots of possibilities and has the potential to transform warfare across different scenarios.